Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG chick. I'm gonna get to this, that's the main quest. Before we're gonna deal with this, entering the Endless Gate. Oh, I have to do that too. Find the owner of the mirror caster. I found a mirror caster of all things inside Marcissa's tomb. I don't know why it's there, but I have a feeling I know who it belongs to. The man in the memory, the cast-off behind all the horrors of the valley. So, these two we're going to be doing this episode, or several episodes put together. At least that's the way I'm planning it. This, we need to find him a doctor or someone knowledgeable. I'm thinking there might be someone back in Sega's Cliffs. Either that or someone we haven't found yet. We haven't come across. And we need to, like, yeah. We need to go back to Mielavest to take care of this. Get rid of it in order to cleanse the portion of the labyrinth. But that will be another time. For now, if you touch that again, nothing else happens. But this... Twisted metal mirror caster. The unearthly metal of this device appears to flow as you examine it, twisting itself into impossible angles. Its branching limbs cross and interweave in a lattice that shows no clear pattern. The device seems to push against the palm of your hands as if willing you to use it. Oh, who am I to say now? Yeah, it's basically the same as I just read. Its surface is hot and somehow restless, as if it wants to move but cannot. Soft nubs press into the soft flesh of your palm, pulsing gently, but when you turn the device over, there's nothing there. The silent voice of the mirror within sings to you, calling you to join it. Let's gain access. Someone has twisted this mirror caster out of alignment. It would be impossible guesswork to put it in a proper state again. Oh, crap. Trying to interact with this. The scrawls and scratches remain, as does the deeply carven sigil. Marcissa. That's the other mirror caster. Find the owner of the mirror caster. Cast off behind all the horrors of the valley. Huh.
Let's go.
Well, we might not be doing this right now. I'm wondering if it's maybe one of the cast offs in Mielavest. Either that or someone might know what to do with it.
Yes.
Let me just check, see if any of these people know anything about it. Nope. What about Melmoth? It might not be. Dearest? belongs to a man, but then again, she might know something about it. Oh, there was one castoff who said return to me when, after you talk to somebody. I don't even know who that is now. I think it might have been that blue guy. Pity you never knew the first. You'd have liked her. If only our creator were here. I don't want to stay here, but I haven't been to the world for a decade.
Of course.
This thing we get to, like, see ourselves eat and sleep and stuff. You return to the vision of you sleeping, snoring like a calorail. Yeah. Shows us our future, but we're not doing any- it's all mundane tasks, which is strange. You are the one who fell from the stars? Don't let the others worry you too much. Meh. They eye you warily. I hope the shields hold. I shouldn't talk to her. I should. I don't remember if you asked them. I guess it isn't any of these people. I understand wanting to avoid the sorrow, but the folks who live here never live, you know? Piss off. Got no interest in talking to a newborn. So sweet. I cannot contain the sweetness. Okay. You know what?
Go.
Let's complete this quest. We have to kill ourselves to return to the calm. Let the structure kill you again. Again, you force your hand through the repulsive waves and onto the structure. You go blind immediately, feeling yourself falling into a bottomless darkness through clouds of slimy, probing bodies. Something powerful crushes your heart within your chest, and then you feel nothing.
I can't die.
Nope, we can't. So how did the first die, if we can't die? Or maybe that's why we're an improved version. Every cast-off is an improved version of the one before it. Yeah, that goes back to the Darth Fathom, or at least it did.
Ready.
Yeah, we can talk. Go talk to Aretas again. Oh, that's bigger now. Can't you think of any way we can get those demons out of you? Healers might, or doctors. So, that goes back to the Clock Fathom. And I think we need to go there right now to take care of this quest. Cast a sorrow fragment out of the Clock Fathom. It's undoubtedly still there. I must find a way to get rid of it in order to cleanse this portion of the labyrinth. Okay. And, what's her name? Told us that we should take care of... I have so much trouble remembering her name. No, it's two A's and two I's. But anyway, yeah. The main, protagonist in Mila Vast. She told us we should take care of all of our other business before we go into the mirror to go visit Mazov, so let's take care of our stuff here.
Yes.
As you cross through the portal, you hear the ringing of synth plate being battered, followed by frantic shouts. So yeah, it's funny how things don't go the way you thought them to. We need someone to find to fix that twisted mirror caster. Or we need to find... Yeah. I don't know. Maybe that person is in the Endless Gate. Maybe we'll come across that person. So anyway... So I thought we'd be doing that, going into a mirror and going through the little story and stuff, which I really enjoy. But instead, we're doing this. And then we're going to go... I guess next episode or whenever, we're going to go through the Endless Gate once again. Deviatiku says, "Focus, Valon. Keep the beast away from me. I just need a little more time." You think focus is my problem? This is a piece of the Sorrow, not some broken hound. Kamo spots you. Ooh, look at that. Over the writhing haunches of the monster. "Brothers, calm yourselves. Our friend is not lost as we feared. She will help." Deviatiku says, "Strange. I saw it place a barrier against you mere seconds ago. You broke through so quickly." It shakes its head. Or he shakes his head? "No matter. I have an esoteric that may banish this creature, but I need a few moments longer to prepare it. Assist Kamoz and Valon in defending me, so I may do so." Okay. Valon says, "Or, you know, she could help. How do we know that ritual of yours will even work?" "Complete your esoteric, Deviatiku. I'll help them fight it off." "As you say, if you have any knowledge of the Numenera, you might also assist me, speeding the process. Get over here if that is true. Otherwise, I will complete it myself." Oh. Maybe I'll assist him. I do have, you know, mystical and natural and some mystical... not mystical, machinery lore. The Sorrow fragment snarls at Valon, preparing another assault. The threat of violence triggers a reflex deep in your mind, and you subconsciously begin to summon reflections of your current companions. Allow them to join us.
This should be useful, my friends.
Okay. So can he use the sucker punch? Attack! It's pretty strong. Eritus? I'll have him sucker punch it too. There's only one enemy available. Nice. It's like almost half dead. Cool. This is me. So I can talk to him. Right, so I have that option. I can get all the way over there? Okay. Deviatiku's arms fold and extend in peaceful undulations as he drones a language you do not understand. Motes of light float around his hands. His eyes meet yours. "It is a complex esoteric I devised to protect against the Sorrow. I regret I was never able to make it strong enough for that creature, but perhaps it will be able to aid us here." You watch his arcane gestures and listen carefully to his words. The ritual is vastly complex, but you begin to recognize a pattern within it. So our mystical lore helps with that. Divyadaku notices your attention. You understand? Perhaps you can assist. With two of us, we might complete the ritual more quickly. Try to mirror his gestures or chant a complimentary verse to amplify the esoteric. I think we're better with mystical and perception than quick fingers and concentration, so these might equal out. Let's try a complimentary verse. Seems interesting. Oh wait, we can't choose these. Damn it. Leave him to it. It's wounded, friends! We can defeat it! I want to zoom in, but I can't while other people are going, I guess. Yeah, let's try to see. I'm only fighting one thing, so... Of one, this consumes movement. Teleport to a point within ranged. So she can teleport. She can't. She can only teleport like here. Can we use this though? Let's do the teleport thing, because I've never used that before.
My sisters lend their strength.
Okay, so she's phased now. Converts all damage to transdimensional and grants +30% invasion and +3 resistance. Except, if I'm hit by transdimensional, the damage is doubled, +100%. Now, it's still out of range. That acts as a movement, I think. Can I cast transdimensional onslaught now? Oh, looks like I can.
Come, taste your death.
Nice. What's it doing now? Ooh. It sucker punched him? It's really damaged. And we're okay. And it looks like everyone else is pretty much okay. Cool. What does this do again? That's flex skill. I just have him attack. It's almost dead. End his turn. Doesn't even do that much damage. Mental?
Ha! Try this out.
Updated my journal. With the fragment of the sorrow gone, you feel new connections being made in your mind. It's as though the sorrow itself were keeping you from your full potential. Oh, sweet. Kamo says, oh, well done. We are in your debt multiple times now. Villon says, in her debt? It's her fault we're trapped here in the first place. By my count... He stops and stares at his hands. They're transparent and becoming more so. Hey, what's going on? Intriguing. Diviatico looks at its hands and feet, which are fading in the same way. We are no longer tied to this place. Our consciousnesses are finding a more suitable location. I guess Diviatico is an it. I can feel the pull, it thinks, as though my memories are being sifted for material to create something new. What does that mean? Villon says. Are we dying? Are we free? Neither, I think. You can see through Diviatico's, well, now they say his, head and chest. It means this part of the mental construct is not ours, not truly. We are being drawn to some place that is. Camoes places a hand on your shoulder. It feels solid, though you can hardly see it anymore. Farewell, friend sister. I don't know if we will meet again, but until then they are gone, and you are alone. Even my friends are gone. What the hell? Did we gain... Oh, I still have 19, okay. I thought I went down to 15 max. Well, disappointing we couldn't help him with that. Are we... Wow. We only need 11 more points so we can get to the next thing. Hmm. So, completed. I have driven out the sorrow fragment that remained in the Clock Fathom. So now we only have these two, which I'm thinking both still lie within the Endless Gate, possibly. We still might find the owner of the Mirror Caster. I don't think it's anybody in the Valley of Dead Heroes. I mean, it's right outside the gate. Right outside the gate for the Endless Gate. Two gates. But I'm thinking that the owner is within. So hopefully we'll run across that person. So there's nothing to see here. Alright, so we're just going to return. All right.
I'll remember that.
Ooh. Where are we going? Oh. The Spectre looks worriedly to a different corner of the calm. A new portal has appeared where there was only empty space before. They're in there, he says anxiously. Defeating that first fragment opened up the way, but there are a lot of them in there. I can feel them. They're feeding on your mind. He gives you a nervous smile. It's probably better to get rid of them, but I don't know if you can. You'll have to be strong. Stronger than you are now, I bet. Huh. What should I do now? You have to find Mazoff. That name tickles our memories. I'm sure he can help you fix the chamber. Then we'll find a way out of this mess. Huh. Find Mazoff. He should have the answers. Good luck. So that goes to the Sorrow's Fathom. Yeah, he's saying I should... gotta be stronger than I am now. So we're not gonna deal with that, and then we'll return to the Ninth World. They're in there, he says.
Yes.
flash of light. Whew, you're a slow learner, I see. No, I did that on purpose. As a means to an end. Infestation. Ooh. Fragments left by the Sorrow's incursion have wormed their way deep into the labyrinth. Like plagues in my mind, they are stunting my potential. A new portal in the calm leads to the fathom the Sorrow's fragments have infested. I must destroy or contain them if I hope to get rid of the Sorrow's interference in my mind. Which we have to gain levels or get better equipment in order to do so. Or both. So, off-screen, guys, I'm going to run back to the entrance to the necropolis, sleep for free, and we'll do that. I will head back to the Endless Gate. Just want to take a quick look. This is too... What a coincidence. Exactly the amount we need. But I don't want to use up all my money in case we need it to rest elsewhere where we need to pay to rest elsewhere. Because we can't get out of the Endless Gate through conventional means. Unless there's just an exit on the other side, but we'll find out about that. I mean, this will still have 103 left over. But every time we have an option to rest somewhere, except for the free one, it gets more and more expensive. So, I'm gonna skip on... I really want this, this, and thirdly, this as money becomes, because it's only one resistance every time. And actually, we only have one of them. So, is one resistance really that much difference? Dunno. Dunno about that. So, I was glad we didn't have to use any of our stuff. We have plenty of healing and everything. We have, for the most part, increased weapons. This is actually a pretty decent shield, what we have been finding. And his is the same, 15%. We need to find a better shield for her at some point. And he can't use a shield because that's a two-handed weapon. So, thanks so much for watching. Guys, I'll see you back, if nothing else happens in the meantime, I'll see you back at the Endless Gate. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.